stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till He appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Christ was born. Oh, night divine. Oh, night. Oh, night divine. Truly He taught us to love one another. His law is love, and His gospel is peace. Chains shall He break, for His child is our brother. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise we, let all within us praise His holy name. Christ is the Lord. Then for
the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Yes, sir.
Merry Christmas to you all, to all who are here with us, and those who are participating with us at home. We gather together at this extraordinary time to celebrate Christmas this year. In the midst of the trials that we have experienced, we've also experienced a number of graces, and we give thanks for the graces that have been given to us, and we thank God for the great mystery of His coming among us as a child today. We now pause for a moment at the beginning of our celebration to acknowledge our need for God's mercy. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks, we have great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who have made this most sacred night radiant with the splendor of the true light, grant, we pray, that we who have known the mysteries of His light on earth may also delight in His gladness in heaven, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwelt in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing, as they rejoice before you as at the harvest, as people make merry with dividing spoils. For the yoke that burdened them, the pole on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaster, you have smashed, as on the day of Midian. For every boot that tramped in battle, every cloak rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for flames. For a child is born to us, a son is given us, upon his shoulder dominion rests. They name him Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful. From David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be
Thanks be to God. Christmas is the most human and accessible of all the Christian feasts. Why? Because God makes himself accessible to us in the person of a baby, a child. And what is it that draws us to a baby? Not just that they're most often pretty cute. I'm told, by the way, that I was an exception to that rule. But it's their vulnerability, their defenselessness, that calls out to us and elicits our love and affection. If ever we could take the measure of why God chose to enter the world in this way, why the King of the universe should come to us as a baby, it would have to begin there, that God wanted to draw us out of ourselves and make it easier for us to love God. We should think about that. God wanted to draw us out of ourselves and make it easier for us to love him. There is also, I call it a gritty side to this. And I think this year we can relate to this side of Christmas especially. Imagine God putting himself at our mercy in this way, making himself defenseless in a decidedly inhospitable world where there was no room for him in the inn, and where the powers that be were intent from the beginning on getting rid of him. The fact is, the world is always more or less inhospitable. But the beautiful proclamation of this night is that God has chosen to be with us in the midst of our broken world and of our torn social fabric. I am with you. Could there ever be a more deeply consoling affirmation? I would say, especially this year, perhaps the saddest of all the realities of this year has been the experience of isolation for so many. I am with you. God has pitched his tent among us poor wretches. He joins himself to our humanity in every dimension of that humanity. At the same time, he never ceases to call us out of ourselves, to be a light in the darkness, to try to love our brothers and sisters a little bit better, and to have a special care for those who are especially vulnerable and defenseless. I think that's where the repairing of our torn social fabric begins, with you and I taking up the path of discipleship more generously and more lovingly. The lights of our Christmas vigil surrounding us here speak of a simple truth, that we who have been enlightened by Christ at baptism and strengthened by the food of his own body and blood are called to let our light shine through in the midst of this darkness. That light is stronger than all the powers of darkness. Together now, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Amen.
With trust and confidence now, let us bring before the Lord our prayers and petitions.
For the church, here and throughout the world, that our worship and praise may give glory to God, and our witness, ministry, promote peace on earth, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a spirit of connectedness, that as the birth of Jesus united God with humanity, we may grow in our relationship with God and with all who walk the human journey with us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are away from home this Christmas season, particularly members of the military, that God will guide their movements, preserve them in love, and bring them home safely. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to the coronavirus, that God will end the pandemic, help the human family to develop immunity, and guide all who are administering the vaccines. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the families of St. Rose of Lima, for whom this Mass is being offered, that Christmas may find them united in the love of Christ and community. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for the love which shines so brightly in the life, death, and resurrection of your Son, Jesus. We ask you now to hasten to help us in our great need and to answer the prayers we offer in your name. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And as our gifts are prepared, please enjoy this beautiful Polish Christmas carol.
Oh, my God.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all this holy church.
May the oblation of this day's feast be pleasing to you, O Lord, we pray, that through this most holy exchange, we may be found in the likeness of Christ, in whose own nature is united to you, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Rose of Lima, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Of the world, have mercy.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
As you come forward to receive the body of Christ, please hum Silent Night.
Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, that we who are gladdened by participation in the feast of our Redeemer's Nativity may, through an honorable way of life, become worthy of union with him who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go now in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas.
And even though you can't sing, you can celebrate the Christ child and clap that COVID right out of the air.